Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Media here. Today we're going to be talking about common problems and reliability with GM's relatively new 6.6 liter L8T gas engine that's used in their HD 2500 and 3500 series trucks as the alternative option to the L5P Duramax. If you guys want a short synopsis or you're thinking about buying an L8T, the quick answer here is these engines are extremely reliable. So far, there have been very few problems that have arisen with them. And so they're great engines. If you're considering one, you're gonna have no regrets with it. People love these engines. They love the power that they have to offer, but there are just a few potential drawbacks and some basic maintenance things that I do want to discuss when it comes to the reliability of these engines. So before we get into the reliability side of things, the L8T is about $10,000 cheaper than the Duramax L5P. I did a video previously covering the L8T versus the L5P, but with just two reasons, I'll go ahead and tell you why you would choose the L8T over the L5P. One, because the L5P is an extra $10,000. And two, because the L5P is a modern diesel engine that has a lot of emissions components on it and potential problem points, whereas the L8T is a very simplistic engine compared to the L5P. So it's gonna offer you a lot more durability without all of the headaches of owning a modern diesel. One of the best things about the L8T from a reliability standpoint is GM decided not to use their AFM and DFM technology on these engines. And there's probably a good reason that GM didn't put that on this engine, and that's because these are heavy-duty work trucks. Ultimately, GM has observed plenty of issues with their AFM and DFM systems over the last 10 years. And so when we're talking about a heavy-duty truck engine that people expect to last 300,000 plus miles, you just can't put that technology on it because that technology is not good. So this engine has a fantastic starting point without having AFM or DFM on it. Like I mentioned, it's very simplistic. There are very few problems that have come up so far. Let's go ahead and talk about a few of the things that we have noticed with these engines, as well as a few of the main complaints that people do have with these. The first thing is going to be excessive oil consumption. I will say that this seems to be very rare. There's not too many people that experience it, but there was a bulletin put out for some of these engines seeing something around 1 quart of oil usage per 1,000 miles or so, which 1 quart every 1,000 miles isn't great, but that's in very severe cases. Again, it's not common that people experience this, but I've seen a lot of the people that do experience this saying it's more like 2,000 to 5,000 miles for them to burn 1 quart of oil, which isn't necessarily a huge problem. One of the main reasons that this does have some oil burn or oil usage is because it is a direct injected vehicle. Being a direct injected engine comes with a few key differences versus port injection engines that ultimately lead them to use a little bit of oil. The excessive oil consumption isn't a significant issue. The one thing you just have to watch out for is making sure you don't run low on oil, because there has been a case or two of excessive oil consumption on these engines where the engines then were starved of oil and had issues with the timing chain. Again, not a problem on this, just be aware that some engines do experience this and that you want to make sure it's topped up on oil. Second thing is, like I mentioned, they are direct injected, and direct injected vehicles do tend to experience more frequent problems with the fuel injectors, the high pressure fuel pump, and carbon buildup. So those are a few things to be aware of. I wouldn't be concerned at sub 100,000 miles, but once you start getting up to the 150,000 to 200,000 mile mark is when you'll likely want to start looking into cleaning off the carbon buildup by doing something like walnut blasting. And that's also around the same time you might start running into a few fuel injector things. But overall speaking, none of these things are problems yet on this engine, but it is still relatively a newer engine, and direct injected vehicles just naturally have more problems with fuel pumps, injectors, and carbon buildup. So something to be considerate about for the long term with these engines. My third thing here is these engines use the oil life monitoring system that can allow you to go all the way up to 10,000 miles without an oil change. Now, this is a heavy duty truck engine. If you want it to last 300,000 plus miles like it should, you should change your oil every 5,000 miles. and not every 7,500 or 10,000 like the oil life monitoring system might suggest. If you want these things to be reliable, especially at higher mileages, and to last a really long time and be able to do what an HD truck is supposed to do, change your oil frequently. Another thing is some people think that they hear lifter tick on these engines, but that really, I think, is just the sounds coming from the direct injected system. Fuel injectors on direct injected systems tend to have a little bit of a ticking noise, and so if you're not used to driving a direct injected vehicle, you might think that that ticking noise is coming from the lifters, because lifter tick is a common thing on V8s, but it's actually just the fuel injectors, so nothing to worry about there. And then the one thing that I will say people complain about is just the fuel economy. I think you kind of know you're getting poor fuel economy because the stated fuel economy is not very high. Most people see a combined about 13 miles per gallon on this, but if you are doing some heavy towing, you know, 10,000 plus pounds, it's not unlikely that you're gonna be seeing 8 to 9 miles per gallon of fuel economy. They are gas guzzlers, but they have a pretty high 18,000 pound towing capacity. So you get what you get when you're talking about a heavy duty V8 6.6 liter engine that can tow a lot of weight. So that really covers it on my few things to look out for on these engines. I will say from a design standpoint, these are very strongly designed engines. They're even selling the L8T as a 550 horsepower crate engine. And so considering these trucks only come with about 400 horsepower, there is plenty of power, room, and potential within these engines if you wanted to do a performance build. But even just aside from that, from a long-term durability standpoint, when you build an engine that can handle 700 or 800 plus horsepower, and then you only run 400 on it, you have a fantastic recipe for long-term reliability. And so these engines were designed very strongly with durability and reliability in mind. And ultimately, I don't think you'll have any problem getting these things to the 300 plus thousand mile mark, so long as you take care of them and don't listen to that oil life monitoring system. Anyways, guys, that covers everything I had on the L8T. Like I said, there's not much here because it's a great engine and there aren't any problems with it. So if you guys appreciate this video, please click the like button, subscribe to our channel, and stay tuned as I will do more videos and create more content on the L8T engine in the future.